Right. Hello there people, long time no see. What have I been up to? Well, I'm doing all the little bits and pieces that take forever and a day now. I've got these corner, I don't know what you'd call them, rubbing strakes, impact pads on the corner of the van. They're stainless steel, and as is usual with stainless steel and aluminium, the paint, it doesn't really stick, it likes to peel off. The person who had it before me didn't primer them. So at the moment I'm spending hours and hours and hours scraping all the paint off with a Stanley blade, rubbing it down, etch primer in it, and then I'm painting it with a stone guard. I'm not sure if you can tell, you can hear, it's quite a, well, it's not a stone guard, it's a truck bed liner, that's what it's called, truck bed liner. I'll show you the make of it in a sec. I'll show you what they look like before they get painted. I've got these rubbing strakes along the side of the van. Not everyone's got them. I think it's just because it's a Southern Ireland ambulance, they came with them. But you've got these stainless steel corner pieces. They're just, they don't dent as easy as the aluminium does. So, but they've been painted, as I say, but the paint is literally, you can just scrape it off with your fingers. I mean, these were all perfect. One drive down the M4 and they're like this. So I'm redoing them in that bed liner. I just like the textured feel of it. This one's going to be the hardest one to do. Try scraping, what's that, 8 foot of aluminium extrusion. I'll show you how I get it off in a minute. We'll go into the garage and I'll show you what I've been up to. Right, just to give you some idea, this is a pretty thick sandpaper. This is P100 or 100. Let's try it on this side, I've already stripped. Now you want to rub this stuff down. It's coach paint, it's really thick and it's actually quite soft. So you can sand it. As you can see, you start to work your way through it. I mean, that stuff, that's like 20 seconds of trying to sand that little section there. Didn't really do a lot. Using a scraper, let's see if I can do this on camera, not off camera. Once you get a start under the paint, you can pretty much strip it in no time. Like I said, this is anodized aluminium and it wasn't etch primed, so the paint didn't stick. I mean, it stuck to a certain extent, but it starts to chip off in a few places. Water gets under it, the weather gets under it, which is mainly water. Couple of winters, next thing you know, you've got little bits and pieces hanging off and it looks crap. I mean, the whole van has been roller painted, so it's never going to look brilliant, but it's that sort of utilitarian aesthetic that I like. Occasionally you get really, really thick parts like that, but other than that, just a blunt Stanley blade. I mean, you see it's got chunks taken out of it, but it's done that much in the same amount of time it took me to do that much. Right, here you can see I've rubbed it all down. I totally overestimated that, and it took 2.5 hours to do that big long bit. The paint wasn't very sticky on it. It came off quite well with a new razor blade. All I do is I just put a little bit of Gorilla tape over the top of the razor blade. Yes, I cut myself, sorry, not being rude to you, I cut myself. Ironically, whilst taking the new razor blade out of its razor blade box. As you can see, covered these with etch primer, just Simonet's etch primer. I prefer to give them lots of light coats rather than a heavy coat. It dries quicker, there's less chance of runs obviously. Then I'm going to give them another coat with this Autotech professional truck bed liner. Right, I'm sure I'm going to get blasted for this, but I like to give it a light coat first. Just to let it dry and stick to it. Then when you're finished, turn the can over, and give it a spray. The pickup nozzle for this can's down the bottom in the paint. If you turn it upside down, you're just spraying gas out and it cleans the nozzle out, and you won't end up with blocks nozzles like this. That is literally going to take minutes to dry. It's very, very thin. Doesn't mean I have to drop it though and mess it up. Come on, Double D, stop something about. Let's turn this round. And then give it another light coat from this side. Remember to get all the bottom bits. And invert and clean out. Don't forget to invert and clean out, people.